The USS Voyager's return from the Delta Quadrant and all the information it brought with it was a major benefit to Starfleet and the Federation for when it came to understanding the Delta Quadrant and the species that lived there, so naturally they had to go back. Right? Right? Welcome to Trek Central, my name is Captain Jack, and today we're exploring the events and characters surrounding Starfleet's mysterious Project Full Circle. The novel, Full Circle, by Kirsten Beer, is the first in a running of series of 10 books from the same author, chronicling the adventures of the Project Full Circle fleet. Full Circle was an initiative sponsored by Starfleet to send an exploration fleet mission back to the Delta Quadrant. The kickoff novel takes place after the events of Star Trek Destiny series and exists in that continuity. If you want to keep up to date on all the latest Star Trek news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Trek Central. You can also follow us on social media for daily updates on the Star Trek universe. Let's do it. It took 7 years and the intervention of a time-traveling admiral from the future to finally get the USS Voyager back home from its unintentional banishment to the far reaches of the Delta Quadrant. Over the course of that 7 years, the Intrepid-class ship and her crew picked up new information, techniques, and technologies that didn't exactly come stock on the ship when it launched. Starfleet, it turns out, was very interested in unpacking every aspect of Voyager's ordeal, so much so that they gave the Endeavour a name, Project Full Circle, and assigned a captain to lead the team. Next on the agenda for the project was to break Voyager back down to its original design, removing all trace of new technology, including the futuristic modifications made to the ship by Admiral Janeway, as well as the Borg technology added in the final days of the journey. The idea was to put Voyager back into service as a standard Intrepid-class starship. In the background of all this, the powers that be were planning on another phase of the project, that would send Voyager, and a small number of specialized starships, back to the Delta Quadrant to expand on the work the crew started during their time there, and to answer an important question, are the Borg really gone? Now might be a good time to provide a little bit of context. The Full Circle novels exist in the Star Trek Litverse, a continuity in Trek which includes the shows before 2005 and many books, including the Destiny series of novels, which revolved around a race of people known as the Kalar, and a massive Borg invasion that crippled the Alpha Quadrant in 2381. At the end of these novels, spoiler alert by the way, the Borg are absorbed by the Kalar, who then split town, leaving the Alpha Quadrant to lick its wounds and recover from a devastating Borg invasion of 2381, that successfully, and tragically I might add, crippled many Alpha Quadrant powers. In 2381, when the Full Circle fleet leaves to explore Borg space, Admiral Janeway is dead. Chakotay, who was in a relationship with her before her death, is the captain of the Voyager. Tom Paris is Chakotay's first officer, Harry Kim's lieutenant, finally getting a well-deserved promotion might I add. Ilana and her daughter Muriel have faked their own deaths and fled to the Delta Quadrant. Tuvok is now serving aboard the USS Titan under Captain William Riker. Seven is Nine is taking care of a dying aunt, and the Doctor is, well, the Doctor. As the fleet takes shape, it's revealed that neither Chakotay nor 7-9 will be making the journey. The expedition is led by Admiral William Basti and the newly minted Captain of the Voyager, Captain Asfar Eden. The fleet consists of three main starships, Voyager and two Vesta-class starships. Each of those three ships was given its own dedicated science vessel for support, rounding fleet out at 9 ships in total, are three more specialised vessels that serve to support medical, engineering and agricultural functions. Things are going to be a little bit more easier than they were for Voyager during her original trip to the Quadrant. Slipstream drives, for instance, make it much easier to travel between Alpha and Delta Quadrants. If necessary, and it does become necessary, slipstream capable starships can replenish the crews, supplies, or even the whole ships within the fleet. A set of communication relays, strategically placed during the trip, allow for much better and faster communication than in the previous trip. Support on supply ships make the fleet less vulnerable as well. So let's take a look at some of what the fleet managed to accomplish, and the effect it had on some of the characters that we got to know and love on Voyager's 7-year TV run. When the fleet reaches its destination in the Delta Quadrant, they come immediately upon the supposed to be dead Belana Torres and Muriel, and save from an attack by a completely unknown ship that looks suspiciously like, but isn't, a Borg cube. At the same time, Captain Chakotay, 7 of 9 and E-Chip have reconsidered staying behind and set out to join the fleet in the Delta Quadrant. The fleet isn't in the Delta Quadrant for very long before they run afoul of Species 8472. As it turns out, Admiral Basti, the commander of the fleet, is actually a sleeper agent for Species 8472. Chakotay once again contacts the 8472 that was posing as Valerie Archer in Voyager's last encounter with the shape-shifting species. A deal is eventually reached that sees the fleet leave the traitorous admiral behind. Captain Eden takes command of the fleet, and upon her decision to remain aboard Voyager, Belana Torres is promoted to chief engineer of the entire Full Circle fleet. The USS Planek is the full First Circle fleet ship destroyed when they are caught in a confrontation with mysterious and powerful species known as the Children of the Storm. Captain Eden reveals that she's not sure of her true origins, but is having visions that tell her she's getting closer. Elsewhere, as the fleet continues to explore former Borg space, Q Jr., with help, managed to resurrect Admiral Janeway, who is very busy being slightly dead. At the same time, within the fleet, a large anomaly is discovered turns out to be something known as the Omega Continuum, an opposite to the Q Continuum and home of the Omega Molecule, one of the most destructive forces in the known universe. Captain Eden, it turns out, is actually being born from the Omega Continuum, when the Q, who are enemies of the Omega Continuum, show up to confront Eden. The fleet commander overpowers them and tries to take them into the anomaly, which would annihilate the Q. Instead, though, Q Jr. managed to convince the Omega Continuum to take him instead, and he sacrificed himself to save the rest of his people, as well as the full Circle fleet. Now, the newly resurrected Vice Admiral Janeway is sent back to Earth for assessment before being assigned as the commander of the full Circle fleet. The fleet also makes contact with a large Confederation planet known as the Confederacy of the First Quadrant. This group consisted of 53 member worlds, and could easily pose a threat to the Federation, should it come to that. When Vice Admiral Janeway returns to the fleet, and to Voyager, she is tasked with opening diplomatic talks with the Confederacy. The more the crew learns about their potential allies though, the more holes they see in their morality and history. For example, things like medical care, food and security are not guaranteed to the Confederacy's people. The poor, and those not conforming to the state's expectations, are left to suffer and starve. Obviously going against the closest held Federation values that all citizens enjoy. At the same time though, an alien alliance known as the Kanara attack and force the fleet to work with the Confederacy. After negotiations, the Kanara asks for Janeway to be handed over to them for trial. The Admiral volunteers and surrenders herself. At Janeway's trial, she is able to reveal important intelligence and cause a rift in Kanara's alliance that allows her to be rescued by the Confederacy, and the fleet moves on, but the two parties manage to part on good terms. While everyone is dealing with the alternate universe version of Captain Janeway, who is leading an army against Vazal on a planet near Kremlin space, yes, the time-manipulating species from the Year of Hell, Lieutenant Harry Kim is dealing with a more personal matter. He has just learned that his current partner, an extremely talented engineer from another ship in the fleet named Nancy Conlon, has been diagnosed with a very serious genetic disorder, but is also pregnant with their child. The mother reveals to him that she plans to terminate the pregnancy. Before Conlon has a chance to act on the proclamation, she collapses with a brain hemorrhage. A complicated emergency surgery had saved her life, also meant the fetus had to be transported out of the womb into a special incubator. Meanwhile, the Full Circle fleet has discovered a large habitation that is strangely uninhabited. The entire Full Circle fleet engages in a mission to solve the mysteries contained here. They learn all of the many inhabitants were built by a race they called the Andridium. Unfortunately, the fleet's presence on the planet seems to set up an auto-destruct mechanism, with energy building to impossible levels. The planet, however, does not explode. Instead, the energy goes into literally pushing one of the system's two stars away, leaving a whole new system in its wake. When the fleet is attacked by a mysterious asteroid slash starship, their sensors show that one of their own ships, the USS Galen, has been destroyed. Rumors of her death begin greatly exaggerated. The USS Galen and her crew, along with Lieutenant Kim, are very much alive, but 47,000 light years closer to Earth than they had been a moment before. The ship is crippled and her captain out of commission. It falls Lieutenant Harry Kim to lead the crew in repairs. Meanwhile, the rest of the fleet discovers that the Galen was transport and not actually destroyed. The crews of the fleet begin to search for a way to communicate with the Andreema. Once they do, they learn the powerful species trying to breach the galactic barrier in order to explore the space beyond. In order to do this, they need a ship capable of slipstream. Admiral Janeway and Captain Chakotay decide that Voyager will volunteer to make the voyage. In the most Voyager move ever, the ship will move past the barrier and will once again be far away from Earth with no means of communicating with home. Before the USS Voyager leaves and the Full Circle fleet goes on this mission, there is some personal business to attend to. First, Nancy Conlon informs Harry that she'll be leaving both him and the baby, turning Lieutenant into a single father who decides to take his daughter to go along a Voyager into the unknown. Tom Paris, on the other hand, elects to take himself, B'Elanna and their two children, the pair had a son during the fleet's mission, back to Earth with the intention to find postings on a family-friendly galaxy-class ship. Finally, Vice Admiral Janeway and Captain Chakotay are married in a small ceremony on board Voyager, before it sets out for its next great adventure, ending a hero's ship's time with Project Full Circle Fleet. The fate of the Borg is revealed within these books, with the Borg collective itself having been defeated and absorbed into the Kalar Gestalt in February 2381. Leaving behind members of Borg Cooperative, a faction of liberated Borg drones. Voyager and the Full Circle fleet eventually caught up with the remnants of the faction, with only 48 members still remaining. Captain Chakotay and the forces of the fleet protected and eventually resettled members of the Cooperative to a planet known as Azeraz, which actually was the first planet assimilated by the Borg Collective, thousands of years ago, so rather fitting home for the liberated Borg Cooperative members. And that is a brief summary of Project Full Circle in the Star Trek Litverse. If you'd like to learn more about this project, we highly recommend the Voyager relaunch novels by Kirsten Beer, which will give you the full Voyager experience. You can find them on Amazon and all good bookstores. That's a wrap on our video exploring Project Full Circle's fleet, and what the USS Voyager got up to. Still some interesting stories to explore, so perhaps we'll do some videos on that in the near future. Share your thoughts with us via this video comment section below, because if you're talking Star Trek, then we want to hear about it. If you want to keep up to date on all related Star Trek news, lore, and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Trek Central. You can also follow us on social media or join our community Discord server. For now, I've been Captain Jack, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Live long and prosper, my friends.